Hello everyone, today we will discuss the philosophy of Schopenhauer, who believed that all changes in the real world follow one principle, which is, the world is my representation. This principle occupies an extremely important position in Schopenhauer's philosophical system. So, what does, the world is my representation, actually mean? Firstly, we need to understand that the world, referred to by Schopenhauer, means everything we perceive, including objects, people, animals, scenery, and so on. Representation refers to the images or phenomena of these things, i.e., how they appear to us. Schopenhauer believed that everything we perceive is only a representation and not true existence. True existence is something called will. Will is a transcendent entity beyond representation, an inner force that is the essence of our life. So why did Schopenhauer believe that the world is only my representation? His view is that everything we perceive is cognized through our senses. Our senses transform things into images or phenomena, which are representations. Therefore, the world we perceive is only a representation, not true existence. In Schopenhauer's philosophical system, the world is my representation has great significance. He believed that only when we realize that the world is a representation can we truly understand ourselves and the world. If we always believe that the world exists as it is perceived, then we cannot truly understand it. In general, Schopenhauer's viewpoint challenges our perception of the world. He reminds us that our perception of the world is only a representation, and true existence is beyond representation. Through this kind of philosophical thinking, we can begin to realize the complexity and diversity of the world and deeply reflect on the essence of ourselves and the world. At the same time, Schopenhauer's viewpoint can also help us face various challenges in reality. When we encounter difficulties, if we can understand that these difficulties are only representations, then we can think more deeply about the essence of the problem and find more effective solutions. In conclusion, although Schopenhauer's view that the world is my representation may be somewhat abstract, the way of thinking it proposes is very practical. By deeply understanding Schopenhauer's philosophy, we can begin to realize the essence of the world and our own existence value, and better face the challenges of reality.
Hello,今天我们来谈谈叔本华的哲学思想。他认为现实世界所有变化都遵循一个原则，那就是世界只是我的表象。 这个原则在叔本华的哲学体系中占据着极其重要的地位。那么，世界只是我的表象，究竟是什么意思呢？首先，我们需要了解叔本华所说的世界，是指我们感知到的一切事物，包括物体、人、动物、风景等等。而表象则是指这些事物的形象或现象，也就是他们被我们感知到的样子。叔本华认为，我们所感知到的一切事物都只是表象。 它们并不是真正的存在，而真正的存在是被称为意志的东西。意志是一种超越表象的东西，它是一种内在的力量，是我们生命的本质。那么，为什么叔本华会认为世界只是我的表象呢？他的看法是，我们所感知到的一切事物都是通过我们的感官来进行认知的，我们的感官会将事物转化为一种形象或现象，而这些形象或现象就是表象。 因此，我们所认知到的世界只是表象，而非真正的存在。在叔本华的哲学体系中，世界只是我的表象有着非常重要的意义。他认为，只有当我们意识到世界只是表象时，我们才能够真正的理解自己和世界。如果我们一直认为世界是真实存在的，那么我们就无法真正的了解它。 总的来说，叔本华的世界只是我的表象观点，是对我们对世界的认知方式的一种挑战。它提醒我们，我们的感知世界只是一种表象，而真正的存在是超越表象的。通过对这一种哲学思考，我们可以开始意识到世界的复杂性和多样性，并且能够深入思考自己和世界的本质。 同时，叔本华的这种观点也可以帮助我们面对现实中的种种挑战。当我们遭遇困难时，如果能够了解到这些困难只是表象，那么我们就能够更加深入地思考问题的本质，并且找到更有效的解决方法。总之，叔本华的世界只是我的表象观点，虽然可能有些抽象，但是他所提出的思考方式却是非常实用的。通过深入理解叔本华的哲学思想，我们可以开始意识到世界的本质和自己的存在价值，并且能够更好地面对现实中的种种挑战。